This free acrylic tutorial is being brought to you by the Ginger Cook Academy of Fine Art and Acrylic Painting and contributions from caring viewers like you. Now, on with the show. And now, without further ado, I have the distinguished honor and privilege of presenting to you the Queen of Color, the Mother of Artists, globally acclaimed, award-winning master acrylic artist, and the star of our show, Ginger Cook, as she once again mesmerizes her audience with the daring do's and don'ts of painting with acrylic.
You're on the air. You're
oh gosh, on. Life's always fun with John. He makes me laugh even before we start the show. Hi, you guys.
What this do you mean? I am totally serious over here.
I know, seriously funny. Anyway, welcome to our Ginger Cook Live on a Monday evening, and thank you for joining us. And really, this is going to be a fun day. What we're doing tonight, which is kind of neat, is we're talking about figurative abstracts. You know, a lot of times you'll see an abstract and it's just shapes and colors, and people will say, I don't get abstracts, or I think I'll just paint abstracts because they're easy. Not necessarily true. Sometimes it's kind of like the ink block test. When you start having odd shapes, it's much easier to see something in a shape and start drawing that in, because that's our natural inclination to translate, okay? So that's what we want to do. So we're not going to go into the rules of abstract, but we are tonight going to be painting in this, I think, a kind of an exciting painting because of the colors. When you think of bulls and bullfights and you know, the energy of a bull and that kind of stuff, Wall Street, you know, obviously, you know, power, okay? This would be a really neat painting. We've talked about this. If you had knew someone that was in the stock market, for instance, if larger, you could paint this larger. I mean, I think would be really cool big. And then, you know, maybe give it as a gift to somebody that, they're kind of a manly thing to hang in an office, I think. Don't you think, John? We don't do a lot of guy paintings, but it's kind of a guy painting, but it could be a girl painting. And I suppose you could just decide not to do it all, this at all, and just paint a unicorn and do the same idea. So, you know, but once you learn how to do this, do this with me, and then, what?
Do a unicorn, really? This is going to translate to a unicorn, this painting?
Well, one that's in trouble, probably. Just somebody found it.
Okay. Sorry. One unicorn coming up.
Okay. So we're going to talk about warm and cool colors. We're going to learn a little bit about that again. And we're going to kind of remind you of what you already know about it and why you know about it. Sometimes it doesn't hurt to go over the stuff. I know, just an example. I love to tell my family history. When my brother, oldest brother was alive, he came down to Houston in about 1990, and this is when the computers were kind of leading edge at that point. Not everybody had one, personal laptops and stuff and computers at home. I think, you know, you could easily put $10,000 into a home computer in a blink of an eye. Remember those days?
Oh, yeah.
It's kind of before, you know, just on the cusp of cell phones. So, you know, he'd flash these notes on my screen. I had no idea how he did it. I was working during the day. He'd go, thank God for Uncle Dennis. And he'd be flashing across the stuff. Because he would tell me how to do something. And then I'd ask him the next day. And then he'd say, I told you yesterday. That didn't mean diddly squat. That was yesterday. Write it down. I need step one. Do this. I need it taped all over. And maybe I need some cheat sheets written on my inside of my arm. Whatever it was. And he didn't understand why he could explain it to me, and I just forget what he said, you know, because maybe I wasn't all that interested. For whatever reason, it just wasn't my passion, so I didn't know. Where then sometimes he thought if he just said it louder. Have you ever had that when you have it in a foreign country and the person doesn't understand English, and they think if you just shout the word, they must be deaf, because honestly, you know, which of course you wouldn't want to do, but you see people do it. Well, this is why we go over and over things, okay? Because I appreciate it. If you don't remember it from yesterday, that's okay. I get it. It's okay. We'll just tell you again. And then, but you know, one thing that I will say is show somebody else and it'll help you remember, by the way. So we're going to, like I say, we're going to be doing this abstract bowl and on a 6x8, but we're going to grid him on. We're not going to trace him on. We're going to grid him on so that if you want to make him bigger, you would just basically do the same idea, okay?
Bigger grid.
Just bigger grids. You know, for instance, did you know how murals are done? For instance, they will grid a wall, and each person will be given their little square, rectangle, and there's like a map, and you paint what's in your rectangle, and when they're all done,
it's supposed to be a cohesive.
And that's how it's done. And the original painting, even as complicated as it has to be, they grid it on. They don't just Leonardo Michelangelo didn't freehand the Sistine Chapel. Just didn't
now,
do it.
Do you know that for sure?
Yes, we know that
Were
for sure.
Were you there?
No, but the historians know, and they have documents of how he did it. And he did it very much like a sign painter does it today. He had the drawings all done, and then he had like a pizza wheel that would punch holes in them and along the lines. And this is how you would do, you know, lettering on signs, say on cars or something. And it's called a ponce something or other. And then it's got powder in it. It goes through the holes.
Yep.
And then wherever the lines are, you know where you're going, right? You're not trying to upside down figure out where stuff is on scaffolding, you know?
This was before Sorel paper.
Yeah, this was before Sorel paper. But even Sorel paper wouldn't have done the Sistine Chapel. So I'm just saying.
How do you know?
Well, we'll have to ask them if they think they could. It'd be an interesting discussion.
If it would.
So let's come on down.
Do you want me to scoot on down?
A real quick,
now?
Fast reminder for you guys to subscribe to our channel. Spread the word. If you like what you're seeing, if you like what you're seeing and you like what we're doing, you can share this with others, share your playlist, share this, subscribe. It's all very good things to do. So, all right, here's our little picture. We've got our bull in the center. I said start off with a background. You start with background, kind of a reddish brown, dark brown, doesn't really matter. We have a bunch of these different backgrounds, and where did we get those? Well, this is just the leftover paint that happens when we paint something. Do I have it? Like if we have a painting and we have it, you know, here's like a palette, right? Well, this
that's pretty well gone.
That's pretty well gone. Well, we'll take these Paramount tablets like this, and we'll take the leftover paint and we'll just cover them with whatever we got. And then we have a lot of red, we'll have a red one. If we have a lot of blue, eventually we'll use it. How's that?
Eventually.
So that's how we do it. So I decided out of all those, I like this one.
Oh, the consensus is in. Your hair looks lovely tonight.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. Appreciate it very much.
Nobody says that about my hair.
Oh, honey, it looks lovely, honey. It does.
It's all my right, earmuffs. So, I got my earmuffs on.
So here's a black and white image of our bull. And what I've done is I've marked halfway and then half, and then divided that into half, okay? And then, you know, go ahead, laugh, however you want to say it, but
I'm not
it
laughing.
Doesn't really matter. You just have to find your halfway point. Doesn't matter how big the canvas is, right? Halfway point. Then here's the next one. We're going to come up here, and here's the halfway point on this. This is a T-square, so much easier. You know, they make giant T-squares too, by the way. Not just small little ones like this. And then we're gonna do this like this. We're gonna turn it around, do the same thing. Find the halfway point here. Line the T-square edge up. Line it up, right? Make sure you have it lined up. Ooh, my glasses on. That is just so helpful. Vision, extraordinary. You have to line this part of the T-square up with the bottom of your picture, okay? Otherwise, the line won't be straight. And then here's this one, this little mark here. Okay, that would be the half of this distance right here. Okay, I think I see it. Yeah, right there, like yay. It's probably close enough. It's an abstract, it doesn't have to be exact, but we're gonna get the general idea, right? Ooh, this is basically how you grid anything, okay? Now, if you have something with more detail, for instance, you've got these squares here, in this case, they're not really all that square, but your little boxes. If you weren't sure, then maybe you would take an X, like for instance here, and you would just divide this one like that. So now you're only drawing,
detail.
You can for fine detail. And then like for instance, this one goes up here like this. You could keep that line going if you weren't sure, maybe even make an X. See that? So if whenever you're doing anything that starts to have more detail, either divide the square again into smaller squares, but you can always just do a slash through it. Yes and yes?
Yes and yes.
So let's see, where did we put this? So we got that, right? So in our first one, we know we've got a horn just coming up like this, kind of goes straight down.
Could you take your grid and slide it a little bit over to your, no, not that paper, the black and white, other way. Okay, yeah, right there.
Here?
Yeah, because I have it on the palette.
Okay, all right, so here this one is, right?
That's kinda, cool.
To draw the negative space in here, do you see that? So look, let me just do this for a second. Take, if you're not sure about something, and particularly if it's kind of not fastened all that well, you know, do something like this if you're not sure. Here, let's do a white line so you can see it. Do something like this so you can see what your shape is. So you see this little shape in here? That's what you're, you know, kind of look for that too. That's your negative shape here. There you go. So this is coming in here like that, right? Yes and yes. So put that over here. Now, what do I got here on the top of the head? Oh, okay, this horn comes out, and then there's the top of the head's almost straight up, and it's about a third here. It does like this, and then we start to see, here's our X going through here. Let's do that, too, so that we don't mix that out, right? So then we've got an ear that's coming almost like this, just a little bit above here like that, and then from the top of the ear, it's coming out and doing this. You know, and you can make some adjustments, okay? But that was a main shape. Now let's come down here for the eye, like this, because the only thing I really care about is his little face, right? Let's make a line here, okay? Now I'm gonna come in, kind of curves out like this, and then at an angle like this, two angle, right? Then here's his little nose that's doing this down here, like this, okay? Now this is an important shape here, this sort of V shape. This is what's gonna bite you in the tush later if you don't get that shape right here, this one. This is kind of funny, where his nose is almost a V, do you see that? And then kind of circles around like this, okay? And then you've got an eye right here, okay? And then let's see, there's not a lot of else, there's not a lot besides the horns, and a lot of color, probably right just on the opposite edge of this, it's coming down like this, just dropping down. It's kind of keeps dropping down like this, okay? And then this stuff is going kind of down that way, okay? So those are your lines, and you can kind of see it here. Those are these are your main lines, okay? And from what you're seeing here, the rest of this is all color. Does that make sense? So I just wanted the, I think that eye's a little big, but I wanted to make sure I had all of this. And then the bottom part of the nose is coming under here like this. And then right down from it is some more dark stuff. I could even change, if I wanted to be less confused, I got it again, just Robin.
Well, talk about those. That's the pencil you're using.
Yeah, this
right?
is the pencil I'm using. This is Robin Coates sent this to. I'm going to mention her name a lot of times because I'm so pleased with this. These Gioconda 24 soft pastels. Let me show you what they do. Look how easy it is to erase something with your finger. That's what I like them. Okay, but let's just say for the sake of I've got a colored painting, and I want to while I'm gridding it right. I want to make sure I have the colors where I want them. So I might take this light green color and just, you know, maybe do some stuff here like that would, you know, maybe I know I've got some slashes and I might just use a colored pencil for a reference if I needed that. But I think you'd probably be okay. There's not very much to this, is there? This was the idea of figurative abstract is you suggest it, you're not really painting it in, okay? So now that we have this neatly gridded, aren't you kind of, see, there wasn't a lot to that, even though it looked like there was. Okay. So let's put this out of the way. And we'll get our guy here. John says he's got it up in the picture. And just if you want to see how many of these, see all the all the backgrounds we've got.
I'd like to have a few ahead.
So, you know. Okay, so then what colors do we want in this? Well, we want cad red medium. And let's see, I put our little grid thing away here. And we want phthalo blue. And in this case, let's see, phthalo blue, cad red medium. We're gonna want a burnt umber. We're gonna want a Payne's gray. If you do not have Payne's gray, you can use purple and burnt umber, okay? That would be your alternate choice. But that's kind of nice for the couple places for this bowl. It's kind of nice to have it. Here's the burnt umber. That's your dark brown. If you don't have burnt sienna, you can use burnt umber. Because burnt umber is sort of a reddish dark brown. Somebody asked about what's Van Dyke brown. Van Dyke brown is almost a black brown. That would work too, probably. It's a, kind of a reddish brown. And then burnt sienna is more of a, the color of a sorrel horse or an Irish setter. There, see, there's that. See the difference in the colors of brown? Those are nice to have. And then what I would like to see is this is an interesting color. This is antique white. The other color you could use is buff titanium or unbleached titanium, or white and a little yellow oxide and brown mixed together to make a light, kind of an off-white color. Kind of a dirty white. Let's see, we've got those colors. Yeah, let's do a little purple somewhere. Yeah, here's some dazzling purple. Put those colors out. Let's see what else. Oh yeah, ultramarine blue. That's your contrasting blue. So you are where? Do we need any yellow? Possibly. We were gonna need yellow oxide. What do you do with all that stuff? Here, over here, here. Yellow oxide. You know me and color. I just love color. Well, if you did our gondola last night, did anybody do the gondola? I mean, look at the color in this guy. That was the video we did last night, a little gondola guy on YouTube yesterday afternoon. And also, we're going to be doing a giveaway tonight. For if you guys want to hang in there for that, John has to make a room, but we're going to do a giveaway tonight. For those who are watching live, watching the live show, we're going to be doing a giveaway. I'm going to put a little white out too. Okay, not too much of that. And let's see, purple. I think we said purple. That was purple, right? Yeah, okay, what else? Yellow. I'm just going to put out yellow because we want something kind of green here. Here we go. All right. Those are our colors. And we should be good to go, yes? This isn't going to take long. This is rough. It would take you longer if you were painting this larger.
You got...
What happened?
What's your top color on your palette? Point to your top paint.
Yellow? Is that too high? You want me to lower it down?
Is there anybody below him?
Yeah, I can just move him. He moves.
That's good.
Look at that.
Who's the guy that's in the who's now who's the top guy?
This one?
What about the one next to it? That's higher. So he'd be the top guy now.
Yeah, that's the top guy. A little higher. Is this a test?
Apparently it is.
This is a test, huh?
And how we doing?
Just perfect. For sure. Oh yeah, I said ultramarine blue, didn't I? I did that. So we'll bring that over here. What's that down here? A little ultramarine blue. All right. Do you guys remember what the difference between ultramarine blue is and phthalo blue? Anybody remember that? Think about that. If you don't know, write it down. Okay. Ultramarine blue. Ultramarine blue is the color of the Atlantic Ocean. It's the color of sailors' navy blue pants. When you mix it with yellow, you get camouflage green, army green. You can think about West Point, it's a military establishment on the west coast of the United States, up there in upstate New York, and they like to wear camouflage, and if you ultramarine blue and yellow make camouflagey colors. They do not make Hawaii green, where phthalo blue, which starts with a P, you'd think it would start with a T, wouldn't you? But it starts with a PH.
Don't get me started.
And so think of the Pacific Ocean and phthalo blue, okay? And and think of Hawaii and tropical green colors. You cannot get a bright tropical green color like this Kleenex box using ultramarine blue. You'll never get it. So it's like cooking and not having one of the main ingredients to make the flour rise, like yeast or something, and then thinking you can't cook. If you don't have the right stuff, you can't mix the colors. But if you have the right stuff, you pretty much can mix all the colors. Now, so there you go. That's the explanation of the day. Weren't you thrilled to know that? All right, now, we're going to use some small brushes today because we're doing something little. I'll put our, no pun intended, Mr. Little. somewhere here in my little box of colored pencils. Okay, so now I'm going to use a half inch angle brush, ruby satin silver. This is the time of day I'd like to give a shout out to thebrushguys.com. And this is those people I buy my brushes from. They carry the full line of Archripper brushes. They carry the full line of silver brushes. And my preferred brush of choice most of the time for small pictures and even for larger ones for detail are the ruby satin silvers. And if you use my name as all one word, regardless of where on the site you shop, when you finally get into the shopping cart, you put the discount code, which would be my name with no spaces, Ginger Cook. They give you 5% off and they ship around the world. Like our friend Sylvia in Australia said that it was such a savings for her, even paying the shipping, the one price shipping, it was still cheaper to buy from them than it was to try to buy in her own country. And we've had some Europeans share that same information with us too. So, and yes, sometimes you'll find like Jerry's or Dick Blick will have comparable prices when they have sales, but these guys,
have a sale.
They have a sale, and here's the thing. They support the art community all the time with this 5% discount. They don't just do it some of the time, right? And so, I like to do, they're a local company, they're two guys own it. They live, I don't know, it's in California someplace, but they're a United States company, but they're committed. It's their business that really matters to them, and you really matter to them. And I like to do business with people where I really matter to them, rather than just, oh, yeah.
We'll take your money.
Yeah. Yeah? Yes and yes?
Okay. Yes and yes.
So that's my spiel for them, and I think that's fair. They don't pay me to say it. I really, truly... Well, we'll tell you all kinds of good stuff we find. You know that. We talk about the tub of towels and all that stuff. If I find something great, even if it's not art-related, I'll tell you about it because I like to... I'm excited to find great things, right? All right. So that being said, let's just start with a little burnt sienna. Okay? And I think, what do I know for sure? I know that I've got a little burnt sienna coming next to here, kind of over here like this, coming around his little face like that, and then a little bit above his eye here like that. Okay. I've got some of that color there. And then, believe it or not, I've got some color up next to his horn. I'm going to leave a little bit of red. I've got a little bit of this burnt sienna color up here above his head. Okay, like that. I'm just looking, it's like a puzzle. Where else do I have a little burnt sienna? Right around here I've got some, kind of at an angle, coming down this way. Going to get rid of some of my lines now, okay? This is all about layers. A little picture like this is all about layers. Can't really see much, can you? Because, there's really nothing to see yet. Let's take a little bit of Cad Red Medium, come right next to it while it's still bright, and come on up here this far and add a little bit of Cad Red Medium here, maybe a little bit down here. And right next to this horn, I'm going to put a little bit.
We have another Australian that heard you about the Brush Guys, and she agrees with the value for the money, even shipped to Australia.
Yeah, isn't that something? I think what's happened is, here's Ginger's speech about this, what's happened is that the people that sell art supplies don't take into effect of YouTube, the YouTube account. Because when you have people from all over the world watching, and there's a lot of artists on YouTube that are teaching everything from watercolor to colored pencil to airbrush to, you guys know, there's thousands, hundreds of us artists out here on YouTube. And between all of us, we're mentioning a lot of products that we particularly use. I know when I watch the makeup people, they've got me. I'm buying whatever that lady has. She looks good. I think that might help me look good. I want that too. Whatever she's using, I want that, right? We're all a little bit like that. So if you won't ship to people around the world, you're missing out on a huge portion of your business, I think. And so, and I like to reward the people that do that, that really do ship. Here's a little bit of this cad red color again. I'm just going to put a little bit of this in here like this. I want to brighten this little area up in here, kind of up, just kind of scriggle some on here. We'll do another layer, but this is all about layers. Let's put a little under his head right here, like this. Just a little bit of this bright color. And then when we do it again, I think I want a little bit of bright, right? I don't know. I'm going to just have it. This will be kind of under stuff, right? Here we go. Maybe something like that. Now, when you're using red, you can't go tootling over and start into the blue-greens, but you can do something fairly dark. So I'm going to take a little bit of purple and ultramarine blue instead of the dark color. I would recommend probably Payne's gray, but if you don't have that, and I will just pretend like I don't have it either. How's that, right? And I'm going to come up right next to this guy, so don't lose this line here, right? Going to come here, and I'm going to do a shadow next to here like this. I want a little shadow, and I want a little dark shadow under here and by my horn. So what I really want is just a little bit of a, here's a little bit of a, like not a full outline, okay? And then under this ear, I'm going to say here's something a little dark right here. See, I'm just going to go for values now. Now this is, while we still have it, this is the tricky part. I'm going to leave a little space and make this sort of V shape here where his muzzle and his nose is. Okay? Like that. It's just, okay? So now I will take a little bit of burnt umber and just come around this like this and maybe a little cad red with it. Make this a little redder, a little more burnt umber. How about some burnt umber here, a little darker brown, okay? Now start pulling in some dark, this is like burnt umber, start pulling in some dark streaks going down here like this, okay? Want something a little darker. It's not as dark as the purple and the ultramarine blue, but it's pretty dark, right? And we're gonna start pulling in some dark ones. Just a few dark slashes. The thing of it is that somebody once said, can you overwork a painting? I remember having a teacher say, you got to be careful not to overwork something. What that means is that if you just keep putting wet color on top of wet color on top of wet color, you get sort of a mess. So try to see if you can do something with like a few brush strokes. Like for instance, have you ever signed your name and then didn't like it and had to go over it? And it kind of looks wonky. That's what you want to avoid here, okay? Here's a little dark up here at the top. A little dark around the ear. Now, I will just take a little cad red while my brush is still dirty and just paint this ear in here like that, okay? He's not really going to show up well until I start putting the lighter colors in. So what we're doing now is here's a little cad red. Let's put a little bit in his horn, right, like this, going up, and maybe put some yellow with it. Let's do that. We can still go a little lighter. Come up here with a little lighter color. I like that. How about a little bit brighter color over here? This has had a chance to dry.
Sorry, I'm having trouble understanding right now.
That's our talking computers. We don't say their names. She who will not be named. The dark at the top of the stairs, right? All right. See how our little anomaly is coming in.
We'll reboot her.
So basically, I'm just working in the reds, browns, oranges, and dark tones.
Pretty much all on the same side of the color wheel.
Yeah, pretty much all over here. See, we're just kind of in the purples and in this side, right? We're not getting it into these colors and our accent colors till the end. Okay. But we are kind of working here like that. And I want a few little dark streaks. A little burnt umber, a little bit of purple. I want a few little dark streaks coming down like this. Okay, this is something dark coming down this way. It's all very subjective, at this point. This painting is done with just a few slashes and stop, right? Maybe got something dark coming up from the bottom like that. Something coming up this way. All right, there you go. So that's our action piece, okay? Now, let's see, maybe I want to curve in on here like this. There's something like that. Okay, like that. Kind of cut his face in a little bit. So I'm going to dry this for a second, but any questions before we dry?
I see no questions.
It's extraordinary.
Everybody knows everything.
Well, this is good. So some questions, some comments, if you haven't seen our, maybe you have the if you haven't seen the Ginger's Gems.
Ooh, the Ginger Gems.
Ginger Gems on YouTube. This is the new things we're doing in conjunction with our, you know, our regular painting stuff, is that they're 5 to 8 minute little short videos on stuff as artists you could, it would help you to know. And we suggest you start a playlist just for them and kind of refer back to them, maybe even make a list somewhere in your notes on the computer, how to draw, how to draw an oval. I think the one, you know, how to tell what the first two we have are how to draw an oval another easily, and tricks for that. And then the other one is how to tell the time of day of shading, say, buildings when it's the sun setting. You know, how does your paint change? So we're going to do a whole series of those, and we'll have those also in our Art Academy, special ones for our Academy members, both on the Wave and Water and Masterclass and on the regular VLL lessons. So these are ones that, you know, not everybody has time to sit down every week. We know that, and watch a full video. Okay, we get that. You want to paint everything, but, you know, you've got laundry to do, kids to take care of, housekeeping, babysitting, you know, who knows what else you're doing. Maybe full-time, 3 jobs. We don't know. So anytime you do tune in and watch us, we appreciate it. Sometimes all you can do is watch, but these little short ones are key, and I'm trying to keep the thumbnails all the same. But on the other hand, if they all look identical, then you won't know what is a new one. So anybody has any suggestions on what we could do to make those thumbnails be the same but still have new ones, we'd appreciate it too. I'm
same
interested.
Same but different.
Yeah, you know what I mean? I want to keep the center part the same, but we have this, I don't know, maybe you got some ideas.
What we're doing is we're changing the text on the right side.
Right now we're just changing the text on the right side, but I don't know if we should change the colors too. On the right side, so that you'd know it was different, a new one. How you would know it was new? So,
I have a question.
Yeah.
Because you asked.
Well,
what's the difference between tones, colors, and values?
Okay. Well,
I happen to have my grayscale.
This is a grayscale. I'm basically.
It's upside down. To
see, off. here's our picture that we just did. Can you see our grayscale?
Yep.
So basically. All your colors, if you were to take this group of colors and just make a sheet and then take a photograph it and do a black and white, they would all fall on one side or not of the grayscale. Now, this is because all white and all black. So most paintings are in the middle three here. So, you know, so a value, and it's a stupid word for it, right? But it is. That's what everybody uses, so we have to keep using it, right? Is really whether something is very black or very white or gray or somewhere in between. It's the gradated value between. For instance, you see the dark here and you see the very light. And on this grayscale, there's nothing really white, maybe a little piece right there. And you can see where these different colors fall on it, okay? Which is why we tell you to take black and white pictures of your artwork as you go and also of what you're using as an example to paint. And make sure that your values match the one you're doing, not just, and that maybe you need to make something lighter, maybe you may need to make something darker. So that would be that's what values are, okay? And we'll answer the other stuff in a bit, but that's the values, right? And then what was the other one, tones and what?
Tones and values. We had tones, colors, and values.
Well, colors are colors, you know, and tones of the same color. You know, you've got a light green and a dark green, and you know, shades and tones of that color. You know, did you add more red to it? I can have something that's very light on the grayscale, okay, a color in here, and I might have a green that has a red tint to it, or maybe a yellow tint to it. It's still this value on the grayscale, but it's got some different tones to it. Make sense?
Wait.
Did you even plug me in?
Well, yeah, I did that.
Okay.
I gotta make sure I get the right microphone.
I have my little. Hey, you guys, you notice that my fun little hair dryer here is was hand painted, and I have a video on YouTube on how to paint yours like this Starry Night. It was really easy to do, sort of fun. People never ask, but it's sort of fun. My hair dryer was getting dirty anyway, and I thought as long as it was getting paint all over, it might say something.
So you might as well have something else, right?
Ready? Yeah.
No, wait.
Not ready yet.
Talk now.
Talking now.
How come you're still coming through?
I give up.
Oh, wait, I'm getting the wrong button.
Well, that would do it.
Talk now?
I'm going to talk now.
Oh, good, you're gone. All right, hey, I wanted to give you guys a freshly reminder that we have t-shirts finally. This is the first of many to come. Website link is right there on the screen in front of you. This is for our birthday batch, which is coming up, very quickly. We have one more Sunday show, and then the following Sunday is the birthday batch. There'll be no show for those 2 weeks live. We will, of course, post something for your viewing and learning pleasure. So just keep that in mind as the days progress. Wait, I got to find you now.
Did you turn me back on?
Yeah, I did now. I had to find you.
You know, have you considered putting little labels on those buttons or little blue dots or something?
I have thought about that, but since I'm moving things around when things work and don't work, I'd have to move my dots. And I forget which dots where.
All right. The other day, for instance, I'm not crazy. This is really a good idea. The other day, I was cleaning out the. I have this little nightstand been collecting stuff. I don't know, for 15 years or whatever. By my three drawers, and the other night was the day I was going to clean that out, and I ran across a bunch of miscellaneous cords. And some of them been there a while. But because I had used my tape.
Your artist tape.
My artist tape. And I had written on there what they went to. Yes, and yes.
Then you could throw them all out.
And then, I did. And I wrote on there what they were and then wrapped the one end around the tape so that I had a tag so I knew what it was. This is not, it's easy. You know, they all start looking like this is the one that goes to this thing. This is the one that goes to that thing. You know, I actually bought, I'm a real sucker for gadgets, right? And some years ago, I have to show it to you. Some years ago, I bought, I thought this would be just nifty keen, this hand massager. You put it in there and it massages your hand. I thought,
really?
It does. I have it.
Really?
I'll show you. It does work, right? And I even put the cord on, put the label on the cord, and then I put the cord somewhere. I don't know where the cord was to make it go, but I had the label on the cord. Found it the other day. Just fun stuff.
So you have both pieces. We can make it work?
We can make it work.
Okay, folks, show's over tonight.
Hand massager. All
hand
right.
massager. I have never in my life heard of such a thing.
Well, yeah, but I have one. just to have one.
Well, you know, you work with your hands
all the time. You do. You constantly work with your hands. Well, you know.
I need one.
I know. I'll let you borrow it. Probably use it more than me. You can, as you're doing, we can put the hand in as you're doing something. You know, you can keep going in it. All right. So let's just take a little of this off-white color and add a little bit of burnt umber to it.
Is the bull's ear in the middle of his head?
I haven't finished him yet.
Don't go there, guys, yet.
Don't go. It's an abstract. You can put your ear wherever you want, right? All right.
It's a Picasso. Get over it.
You know, so now we're going to do a little bit of purple to that. Tone that down. See that? Put a little bit of purple in it. That was that sort of... Okay, now I've got this sort of light color. All right, let's make that color if you didn't have that antique white. Shall we do that? Because some of you are going to say, I don't have antique white. Really don't hate it when you do that stuff. All right. Here's the white. Here's a little bit of brown. A little bit of burnt sienna. Here's a little yellow oxide. A little bit more yellow oxide. It's a little more white. It's a tiny bit of purple. Was that purple? Yeah. Tiny bit of purple. More white. Now a tiny bit of yellow. A little bit more yellow. More white. There you go. So, see, you can make it. Does that make sense? You can make it. You can make it, or you can just, you know, just gonna start with a different base. Now we're going up and down. This is a little smaller brush. This is a quarter inch angle brush. And I want to come under my ear here and use that as part of the outline of the ear, is just the sort of light color here. This is your nice bright, this is probably the brightest color I've got on here. And we're going to come on down here like this and just do some very uneven up and down lines on this. Okay. And now let's come over here like this. And here's the edge of his eye right here. And that's where his ear has to end, right about here. And right up from where his eye is. And his, and then we're going to put a little bit of this light right here on his little nose. Come up here around here like this. Gets skinny. Comes under there. Yeah, yes and yes. And then over here, I want to put a little bit of ultramarine blue with this. Take a tiny bit, just the littlest bit, and kind of make it a little bit slightly greener. It's subtle, but, you know, it's what we're doing here.
Hey, Chris has a question. It's pretty appropriate, too. How do you know how many colors are too many colors in an abstract in this style?
Well, as long
some
as you...
Some people can go really crazy.
It, you know, it's, look, you want predominantly one or the other. You want predominantly either warm or cool colors. And you should have... Look, in this case, for instance, you know, I would say, what would you say the predominant colors were in this? It's probably... Well, this brown's kind of warm,
brown.
And this blue, you know, there's all earth tones. And then we've got this color surprise with this orange and some blues, you know? So... again, some of this, you know, one of the things that people say, I mean, you know, if there was just a rule, then you there's no rule, but you want to keep the, for instance, I add a little bit of blue to this and layer, that's important. I add a little bit of blue to this, you see, and maybe down here I have just a little bit of color. Nothing is ever just one color. Does that make sense? So like here's a little phthalo blue and a little bit of white. Okay. And I'm going to come right under here next to this part of the horn and add that blue. And I know that I want a little bit of it over here too. And then I would just stop and add a little tiny bit of ultramarine blue too. So nothing is ever just one color. So it's not, you know, and for instance, here's some blue. And we were sort of playing with a combination of blues here, kind of swiggling back and forth. There. And see, I had a little of this lighter color on my brush. So look what happened, okay? Now, could you mimic that exactly the same way? No, but you can get the general gist of what you're doing. Phthalo blue and yellow make sort of a pretty green with some white, okay? And maybe even some of this background color. See, look at that beautiful, like, beautiful gray-green, right? So look here, if I put a little of this color down here.
Great color.
Kind of define that. Maybe I want a little bit on his head right here, like that. And push something there, and then I'll put a little more white in it and lighten that, you know, lighter. And then here's a little bit of that right there on his ear. Where could I put a little bit of blue? That's pretty. I mean, I might do this one differently this time than I did the last time. You know, it's kind of how I love that light bright blue, but then maybe I want some blue here like this and just sort of squiggle it like that. You can overdo this, okay? You can overdo this whole thing. It's just a few brush strokes to suggest what you want, almost like shorthand, okay? What you're kind of doing is like shorthand. And
this would be a challenge for the sock folders among us.
Well, the thing with this is that you know, here's, I want a little bit lighter here, maybe something here. Let's do a little more red here on that, right? Want something a little brighter here, because I mean, red's one of those colors you gotta keep playing with, okay? I've got the red because the red in this case indicates to me bullfighting and, you know, that kind of thing. You know, it's there's got a lot of energy in this orange-red color. And so for me, what I'm saying, what can I say with the least amount of, I can do a lot of layers, but the least amount of actual, like, I don't want to outline anything. This has never been about outlining anything, right? I want to suggest that there's a little light purple. Suggest that these horns are here without actually drawing them in. Does that make sense? So here's a little purple up here. And here's a little purple here too. And maybe a little highlight here, and I'll put a little bit up on this one too. I want a little bit there. So it's my purple on my ears, right here on his eye. Okay. Come around his nose like this. There's really not, I'm going to dry it in a couple of seconds. I want some brighter, kind of a phthalo green look to it. So I'll do this with a little yellow, put a little white with it, more white. Okay, now I want something brighter here. Do you see that? Okay, and up here too, I want a little bit of brighter because it just sort of died off on me. So now brush is being rinsed, okay? Now I will go into white, or maybe even this unbleached titanium light color. And then this is my lightest color, which is right here on his face. It's not the whole thing, but some of it's here, right? This light color right here on his face. And maybe I'll take that white and a little of this burnt sienna. I want to come under over his, that's too light, his eye like this. This brush stroke's going here like that. And then I'll take, say, purple and blue. That'll be my eye here, right here like this. Kind of almost like a, the shape is this, okay? In case you can't see that.
Can I be a sock folder if I don't fold my socks? I'm asking for a friend. I think you need therapy.
Well,
of course you can. Don't be silly.
Yeah, you can be a sock folder. Well, not everybody. You know, this is what we call figurative abstract, and it's fun. They're fun to do because I think I got that nose a little lighter than I want it, so I'm just going to tone that down right there. And here's a little bit more of this coming up here like this. My horns. Okay. And then what we got to do, it's almost done, is we want to make sure that we have enough stuff going up and down here like that and across. And put a little brown with that. Don't want that bright. This is where you can really do something with values as far as whether something's light or dark or something. There you go. This is coming this way. That was coming that way. Just something on top of his head. All I want to say, and I think I got his eye a little lower than I wanted, so let's take it out.
Ow.
It's all right.
Art says he's going to do this one 16 by 20. That a boy, Art.
Yeah, I think this would be, I think this could be done very, very well large.
Yeah,
very well. And I want a little bit of outline here around the, ooh, that's too much paint, but around the muzzle of this. Okay, so around the muzzle of his nose. And it's kind of about it. Just, oh yeah, some lighter brown down here on the side. A little bit of lighter color. Just everything's kind of up and down so that you get the benefit of this wonderful cad red color. Here, just a big bright orange thing right here. Look at that, which is cool.
And that.
Yeah. It's the same idea, okay, as Pat the, let me just move this out of the way for a minute. This was Pat the painting dog. Look at that. That's Pat.
Love
and
Pat.
We have a video on how to do Pat. And is that different than this one? Except Pat's got a little more information. This is what we would call stylized art. It's not abstract art. It's stylized. Okay? And this is what we call abstract because Pat has too much information to be an abstract. So he's what I would call stylized painting, kind of stylized form of abstract painting, where the bull is is much more abstract. Where's our abstract horses? Do you have those ones running, those long ones running? You know that, the long horses running? We've got some great abstract horses in our academy that that we did, again, it's stylized, where we're suggesting that they're running. I didn't do it in this one, but I'm tempted to just lighten that up right there. Didn't do it in this one. Just where his eye, yeah, I kind of like that, and just bring it back up this way.
Isn't that that one that we did on the board?
Yeah.
I don't know where that is.
In the closet, maybe? I don't even think we put it in that part. Do you have any? We have a bunch of abstract horses, but I've never done a bull. I'll tell you a funny story about doing cows. I got... And some years ago, gosh, it's been almost 20 years now ago. Seems like yesterday, doesn't it? But 20 years ago, there was a big brancher up here in Texas, out of town. They bred Brahma bulls, and they asked me to paint their brochure, only like huge, like 100 feet tall, and I don't know, it was just extraordinarily big. And so I didn't know the first thing about cows. So she said, it's really good, but you made all boy cows. And I'm thinking, okay. Because I didn't do like genitalia or anything. So I'm thinking, huh, okay, well, whatever. You know, it was sort of sometimes, you know, I'm not saying cows are my best subject or anything, but I don't think it really matters. Hers were pretty realistic pictures. But what you want to do here was something like this. And then this is real important. What you want to do, and make sure that this nose to kind of bend like this. That's very important, like that. Have a little bit of a bend to it. Is you just want that? What you want with a painting like this, is the power of the colors and the lines. Does that make sense? The power of the color and the lines doing this, and that's where, you know, get your lights up there. You know, just something like this. See. That's what you're doing. And then what you could do, if you want to be the last of the, do you ever say that when it'll be the last of the big spenders? This is CAD red light. And I'm going to just show you some color. Look at that. And you go over it with a little of that. See how much brighter it is? And that's a color you really can't. You can add a little yellow to your CAD red if you didn't have it, but I'm telling you that's a, there. That is a color that's just fantastic. And you can sit there and say, well, what about that? And you can go right into, I wouldn't even put my reds out. Here's some red. That's your primary red, right? So, you know, if you wanna, you know, I started off with kind of a red background, but still, if you wanted to play a little bit and have some, you know, that kind of thing. But I personally like the CAD red. But you don't want to overdo it. Now, look, what would happen if you put yellow with CAD red? The CAD red light, what would happen? How light would that be? Okay, let's try that. Look at that. See? So, you know, you can play with colors and have one color that's a little bit of accent. We have this blue-green as the accent of this other one. And then if you wanted to get even crazier, because when you get pure colors out of the tube, okay, then they're a little different than when you mix them. So we mix that sort of phthalo green color. But if I were to take white, phthalo green, see the difference?
Brighter.
Yeah, so, you know, it's just brighter. So that's your color surprise right there. Just one, two drops of that. That's your color surprise. And we're calling, you know, and you call it, you pretty much call it done. And then that's the same thing with that, with Payne's Gray or black or anything else. Here's Payne's Gray. Now let me just show you the difference. We did the dark brown in the ultramarine blue. So if you wanted to just make more of a statement, then you come under here with the dark color, like right here. And it's darker. I can't explain why, but it's darker. So this abstracts are a good example of pictures where you can use black, okay? And we have some black coming down in here like that. And some stuff that's dripping down like this. There you go. And I had some green dripping down too. See that? Let's see, let's just do the darker green. There, okay, I think I'm gonna call it done. Because you can overwork it if you get too many colors, then you lose this. What was nice about this one was I had this big block of color here. So you don't wanna lose all that. Let's put a little bit of Payne's gray in it and just tone it down just a bit. You don't wanna lose all of that. You're darker. You don't want to get so carried away with this that you lose all these. This is sort of your rest color. Your eyes resting with this color. So you don't want to lose too much of that. Okay. So that's why a color like this is so important. And there you go. So that's. Get too much white on something, then it takes away. So a little tiny bit's fine. A little tiny bit's fine. Just put this back here, a little bit of yellow, a little yellow oxide. When can you put, so people say, well, how do you know if you've got too much color? Well, here's a little bit of yellow oxide with that. A little bit maybe in here. So, you know, again, some of it's just how it fits. Does it speak to you? How does it feel? But you can get, let's just kind of take a little of this color and tone that down.
Christine says, I really like the Payne's gray as an accent and contrast to the orange.
Yeah, it shows up a little bit better. And also, you can use Payne's gray to dull down some of these other colors, okay? So, you know, that's the other thing you can use it for, too, because I want the horn to come out here. I want to sit there and feel like my horn is attached to here like that. So that, you guys, is our picture. And, you know, could I play with a little bit more? Yeah, see, part of me wants to still make it look more realistic, and that's not the trick at all. You don't want to, you know. Don't want to do that. You want to just have enough accent to make a picture. So we'll just stop here. That's how you paint it. How you paint it's going to be slightly different than probably how I painted it. And that's okay because, again, it's like I say, I want to have enough of the dark lines here to indicate the body of the beast. Okay? You know, that's important. Make sure we have enough dark like that. But there we go. So fun, right? That's not going to take you long to do. You know how to draw it in. We'll sign it here. People will say, how are you going to sign it? You know, I'm going to sign it in the yellow Posca. That might be fun. I haven't used this yellow one.
Do you want to dry it first?
I'll sign it right there. It's still dry right there.
Okay.
So anyway, let's take it off of the purple. Put it on an orange background. It's interesting, isn't it? Depends the color you put this with. It'll depend on how it looks on something. But it's kind of fun, right? All right, so do you guys know that when you get a new Posca pen, do you know before, after you shake it up, do this and burp it so that you don't get a little glob? I like that color.
Oh, I knew it.
Just a drop of that color in there. Don't you think it needed it? I think it needed it. There you go. There we go. I'm feeling the bowl now.
You're feeling the bowl?
I'm feeling the bowl, absolutely.
I think it's been a bowl of a lesson.
All right, so we'll just stop and do a little, you know, fast, you know, 10-minute...
Brooks, I have a drawing for the one that we forgot to do was the, oh, where is that painting? I know where it is. Excuse me, I'm going to have to walk in front of you folks. Get over it. This one.
Oh, we didn't do a drawing for this yet?
Nope.
oh my gosh, you guys, we didn't do a drawing for this painting. So this was people who entered this back in December.
Yeah. December is up to January 1st. It's only the 14th.
It's only the 14th, sorry.
We're right on time.
We're on time. We got very enthusiastic with this stuff, right?
Busy people.
Right, there's the... I like that pen. Don't you like that pen? Telling you what, this is where all the colors in a Posca pen could have fun with, okay? Absolutely have fun with. So we're going to do a drawing for this one. John's going to find that if you entered for this, we will we'll draw for that. And also there's one at the end of the month, we have the martini glasses and the olives, you know, that we did for sort of the New Year's Day. That painting is, if you entered, there's still time to enter to win that one. And if you're watching live, you can enter whatever I'm going to be painting tonight. How's that? So I'm going to go through my list of colors here and see, what do I feel like?
Alexa, are you working?
Painting.
It seems to be working. If something's wrong, you can send feedback through the help and feedback section of the Alexa app.
Good to know, Alexa. It's always nice to have helpful robots, isn't it?
I'm telling you.
I'm telling you, right? All right.
All right, so where's the link for today's giveaway? There it is.
All right, so if you were one of those ones that entered to win this with the berries and the branch.
We're going to do that drawing
right now. We'll do that right now.
Right
now. No waiting.
Right before your very eyes.
While I'm painting this one, yes? Yes and yes?
Yes and yes. There we go. All right. So I guess how many people entered this one. This is for the branch in the winter. 323. Let's see how Miss Alexa is working today. Alexa, pick a number between 1 and 323.
Your random number between 1 and 323 is 228.
228. And it is Libby Bernard. I've never seen that name on a live show.
So she probably, we'll email her and let her know that she won, right?
Yep.
Okay, so while I'm painting this fun little thing here for our giveaway tonight, I want to do it in a similar style to how we did it before, but in blues. What do you think of that? Okay.
Winter branch painting.
So.
All right, so what do we got going on? Oh, it looks like horsies. Oh, this is going to be the unicorns, I bet, right?
Well, I'm just saying you could do the same style of picture.
You could really do that. I know what you're
just
doing.
Just saying, you could do that, right? I mean, I'm just saying you could, right?
Yep.
And why not, right?
Why not? You're in control.
I mean, once you kind of understand what you're painting, okay? And then, you know, when would you do something, you know, different? So
there's a lot of you knows in there, you know?
Mm-hmm. Well, that's your best right there. That's what you got.
All right, so we take care of Libby, shoot her an email.
Okay, and then if you want to enter this one, the girls are putting up a link.
There's a link you can type it in, or the gals are putting it up there so you can see it. Now, we have one more Sunday show before the birthday bash. It will be at noon. 12 noon will be our last noon show. We're going to go then to 1 p.m. after much negotiations. So look for that. Look for that coming up. This week, we are thinking of doing a... We have one more Sunday and Monday, right? Then the week after will be a Saturday. What are we doing? Do you remember, boss?
Oh, what are we doing, what?
So we have a Sunday, Monday. So the next one will be the 20th and 21st. And then we're going to do a Friday, Saturday, 25 and 26. And we'll get those rooms built up with a generic thumbnail, just so you can mark them down, put them in your calendar. Make sure you have your alarms turned on, you've subscribed, and hopefully you'll get notified. We do not control YouTube's notification system. It's entirely up to them. Some people get notified after the show.
But if you were a member of our free Ginger Cook Acrylic Painting Club on Facebook, even if you hate Facebook, become a member of that, because chances are we're going to tell you then.
We'll tell you there before that, we know anything.
You know, those guys get the notices right away, right?
Yep.
And
so the Birthday Bash crew, we're leaving on the 27th, or if that's that Sunday. Yep. So we will try to do things from the cruise, because we got approximately 40 people joining us for a marvelous time.
Yeah, we're going to have a really good time. I'm telling you what, we've asked people to bring pictures of their artwork, right?
Yeah, we are going to do on-site
personal art coaching, so they can show me, bring up pictures of their painting, and we'll do it for the group so everybody can benefit and see what they're doing. Won't have to be an Academy member. It's not everybody that's going is an Academy member. Now, if I'm going to change, I'm in the cool tones here, right?
Yes, you are.
So I'm all in the cool tones. So if I'm going to change tones on this, any of this, now what I have to do is dry it. Does that make sense? I just threw in the cool tones first. So I'm going to dry it.
Wait. John. Wait.
Okay.
Wait. Talk. Talking. Ha, gotcha. All right, well, she's drying that off. In case you missed, I'm going to take that away for a second. In case you missed yesterday's show of the Venice Canal, we also have in our downloadable lessons a Venice Canal. This is a full-fledged wave and water class. I don't know how long it is. It's 4 or 5 hours total length, but this is one of the many titles that we have available. We're going to add a lot more to our library this year. I told you that last year, but this year we're definitely going to do it, because a lot of people just don't have the internet connection that they like to have to be able to get these lessons.
Yeah, that's...
Wait, boss. I got to find you again. Okay. There you are.
Okay.
You're back on. You can talk now.
I can.
Yep.
Okay.
Print art would be better than on our phone. That way she has something to draw on.
I can't use
your
phone.
You can't use a phone or a tablet. Yeah. Bring a printout.
Bring a printout of it.
Please.
In fact, bring a printout of it.
Preferably 8x10, please. Aren't I being polite? That's looking good.
Okay, we're just playing with the colors here.
How are we doing on entries? Anybody having problems with the entries? Nope. Got 168 so far. The lessons I just showed you, those are downloadable, or you can watch them online, either one. And they are yours to keep forevermore. And if we ever go back and update one, you would be notified to know there's an update to it. We've never done that yet, because they're pretty darn complete.
Yeah, if we decided to update something, right?
Yep.
So, yeah, absolutely. So right now I'm just playing with colors I want to use for this. And
it looks like a mother-daughter.
Could be. I don't know. Might be. Hard to know. Just, so the other thing, you know, tell me about some of the other stuff we're doing too.
Well, we are working on a new, what we're going to consider a college level offering, which is going to be painting design. Which we're going, it's going to be, have a start and an end. It'll be a finite course. And we're probably going to be offering certificates on that one for sure. It's not open to everyone. You'll go through a qualification process, an application process, I guess, like you're applying for a college. There is no college degree. It's not like that. There's no formal test like that, but it's...
But what we're trying to do is that we don't want you to take it if you're not ready to take it. In other words,
we don't want you to waste your money.
We don't want you to waste your money, and we're not trying to be pretentious. But you know, we want you to have a certain level of art skills before you take it. You know, at least that's our plan. Maybe we'll just give up and sell it to everybody and say what the heck. But now, you know, our initial thought, right, which I think is fair, you know, I think it's a good one, is that we really do want to feel like we want you to feel like you can be successful at it, and you have to have some basic knowledge of art for this to be of any benefit. How's that? Does that make sense? So that's coming up, but I don't know when we're working on that, because it's come up for so much that people constantly are doing what they call original. Everybody loves to do what they call original paintings, and they're a hot mess, and they're a hot mess because they don't understand the basics of design, and then you've got to be able to, even if you do that, you've got to be able to be in a position where you can execute it. Does that make sense? Go ahead and execute your picture. So, okay, so let's see, what am I going to do with this?
We haven't established pricing or anything on it yet, so.
No, we're not. We want at least five. It'll be every month. We want at least five videos in before we start it.
Yeah.
We want us to have a basis of at least five videos, yeah? Yes and yes?
Yes and yes. Yeah, it'll always be up there. So if you're not ready today and you're ready in a year, the class will be available. It's not going anywhere.
We're just not suggesting people.
There's not take a start it. And finish to the class, to the time that we're going to be offering it. Just a start and finish that you will be able to accomplish it, in other words. And it's not a set course as far as, you know, in a month you have to do this. It's at your own pace. You'll find out about the course through the Facebook Club and, of course, on YouTube. We'll probably do a little ad for it for YouTube when we get ready to release it.
Yeah. Okay. So now, let's see, I think I'm out of white. Okay.
So that is one of the new happenings. Ginger, are there any pictures of your mother's artwork?
My mother, Lucille Wilkins, my stepmother?
Yeah.
No. No.
In a distant memory.
I think in her book, she wrote the book. I have the book. You have the book somewhere? I can show some pictures, yeah.
You're talking Sword and the Gavel?
Sword and Gavel. I gotta dry this anyway. I can I'll show you this in a second. Let me dry this and I'll finish up this painting. Okay?
All right, while she's drying that off, any other questions? Is there a website? There's nothing on the new classes of yet. It will be on a different website. It's gonna be a different offering and a different membership. It's gonna be a separate entity unto itself.
Let me just finish this up and I can show you guys why he's, you know, sorting stuff out to draw it.
What is the difference between the course and your Ginger Cook Live membership?
Well, huge.
One is going to teach you to design painting. The other one is showing you how to paint.
Yeah, the one shows you how to paint so that you'll have something to design.
So you have the skills then to do your own design work, do your own originals. Become your own Picasso or Monet, Van Gogh. I didn't know there's any pictures in the book on that.
Yeah, there is. There is, for sure. There is, absolutely is.
Well, I would hope so.
Yeah, there is. There is, absolutely is. And I'm just focusing on this right now. I'm trying to get this done so that you can do the drawing. And I put paint down and then I don't know where I put it.
Oh.
It just happens to me all the time. Here it is, some white. I think my white got all contaminated. We're going to have to, we need a little contrast. Let's see, is this still, that's still wet here.
I thought you just dried it.
Yeah, but that liquid color doesn't dry well.
Mm.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
It doesn't, this black right there is,
Is that real black?
Yeah, yes, Payne's gray. Okay. So it just doesn't dry as well as I'd like, right? So okay, now. All right, so now what we're gonna do is let's see, what can we do here? Now I just need something lighter. Because again, it's figurative abstract. We wanna suggest it, but we don't. You know what I mean? But then on the other hand, we wanna say that it all kind of melts in here, right?
Can we take the VLL elephant? I guess that's the elephant of many colors, and do it as an abstract.
I don't know. You could try it and see what happens. They want us to do it?
I think there's too much detail in that one.
I'm gonna just change the eye here on this one.
You've been scribbling out eyes today.
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, they kind of make a difference. So let's put them where I kind of want to go, where I kind of want them to go. Just having fun with this kind of, these weird colors. You know, and a painting like this, I might do 3 or 4 times and try all kinds of different colors with it, right? And see, you know, what worked best for what I was doing. I'd get the basic design, right? And then decide whether I wanted the next something to be, okay? Okay, so now I'm feeling the horse now.
Feeling the strength of the horse.
Yeah. And then I'm saying, where can I go to do something kind of dark here? I want something kind of dark. Because I mean, if wherever there's a dark, there's a light. So if you, so I can come back and darken something, kind of bring the eye down like that. Okay, so it's sort of coming together now. See what I mean? It's that it just takes a while to
develop it.
To develop it. I mean, because if one shape isn't working, then the next one better. Does that make sense? That one shape isn't working, the next one better. Okay.
All right. Get your interest in if you want to get this horsies.
So that one might be better just with the shape here like this. And there's our green coming down like this.
I know you've answered this before, but who is your favorite artist and why?
Well, I have a lot of current artists that I like. It's a current Kent Wallace and Howard Behrens were two of my favorite. Howard Behrens is no longer living, but he was certainly one of my favorite artists. And I just like their color and their use of color. Their absolute marvelous use of color, because that's what I'm about too, right?
The queen of color.
Okay, so.
What about the ODJs? Who's your buddy there?
Oh, I don't know. I really like that Norwegian artist.
You do most of a lot of his stuff.
And Head, that, you know, the guy that does the, that you know, did those magnolias. Those ones, I really like those guys too. There's so many, you know, I'm discovering new ones all the time. I research these guys, and a lot of them, when I bring them to you, I never heard of them either. Does that make sense? Never heard of any of these people. I'm going, how did I miss that? I mean, John and I were watching a history show today, and they were talking about some history of New York City, and I promise you, I'd never heard of any of that. You know what I mean? I mean, I wasn't living in New York, so I understand it, but still, I had never heard of any of that. Let's see if I can do
things
something.
Things that we never were taught in school, that's for sure.
Yeah, they weren't taught in school, right? So, okay, there we go. I just wanted a little bit of something in here like this. All right, so let me stop and go ahead and I'm gonna just go ahead and start raffling it off because
I'm gonna raffle it off here. Last call for the horsies.
There we go. That's it. Now I got that green going. Okay. There we go. Abstract horsies. So let's see. Just you're not doing it right. They're all doing it right. I just want a couple places of brighter color. Okay. Did I have any yellow? Oh, what's this color? I don't know. This is sort of a light yellow. That's pretty. Where could I put that? I'm kind of looking at that, going, where else could I put that? Maybe.
What color is that one?
Kind of, well, just there, but I just wanted to emphasize
the ears
a little more on this.
Okay, I'm going to be closing the form in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5.
Okay.
4.
That's it. That's 3, all we're going to do.
2.
I think. 1. The form's closed, right?
Form is now officially closed. No more responses are being accepted.
Okay, I wanted it just a little bit lighter under that. You know, sometimes you just...
202.
Okay, all right. Well, this one, I'm glad you guys are playing, right? And something kind of fun to do. But I'm just saying that if you look at this abstract, we just kind of made this up in our head, but... you could come up with something like this, right? And just play with it a little bit. You know, then kind of smooth it out later. But I mean, if you feel the energy of horses, right? That's what I'm seeing here. So, you know, the energy of horses. There we go. And I'll just dry this and sign it, all right? In fact, while you go ahead and do the drawing here, I'm going to sign this, dry it and sign it. You're doing something?
Online?
He's busy. All right, well, wait a minute. Let me use my tub of towels.
I think we've lost connection.
What?
I've got a swirly. I don't know what happened. I'm getting the form to come up again.
Just, I think we're still filming?
Well, I know we're still filming locally. And they think it's still good.
Well, okay.
It seems I've lost my laptop as I'm doing it, so let's just see if I can get it over here.
All right, if you guys are wondering what I'm doing here, I'm using my tub of towels. Can they hear me?
I have no idea.
I'm using my tub of towels here to clean all the paint off my hand before I touch my book, right?
Oh, yeah, good thinking.
I just want you to see how easily that cleans up. If I, before I discovered these,
well,
I never
like would have... I don't know, something wrong with the... Who knows? We're here. We're good. We're golden.
All right, so I got to dry that, but somebody asked me to find pictures of what my mother used to do. She studied under some Chinese artists. It's this Chinese artist and art instructor. And so she started off... This was not a colored painting, but she started off with, you know, sort of stuff like this, with the goose and the moon and the bird, and here's some little people under umbrellas.
Style.
Yeah, she had a very oriental influence. And here were some of her Chinese horses, you know, based off of horses that had been drawn in China forever. And I can remember some of those big floral. I can remember some of these. This was one of my favorite paintings she ever did. It was all these jugs. It was all in greens. It was real pretty. And this old cast iron stove. And anyway, that was my dad's study. And so anyway,
this was... I don't see a computer on his desk.
So, no computer.
No. All right, we ready to draw?
Yeah, go ahead and draw. While you're drawing, can I dry? You can mute me.
Yeah, go ahead. Alexa, pick a number between 1 and 202.
The random number between 1 and 202 is 37.
All right. All right, we have a number, and the winner of the horsies is a Mr. Art Thomas.
Oh, Art, all right. Art's going to be with us on the cruise.
Winner of horsies, or
wow.
Seas.
You know, I'll tell you what, Art, we'll bring it to you.
Maybe he wants it before.
Tell us, otherwise we'll just bring it to you. If we remember.
Yeah.
We should just mail it to you while we think about it, right? All right, well, isn't that fun? But, you know, just good for you. I'm very happy for you, you know. Good.
Does he send his work in for PAX? Has he?
Yeah, I think so.
He wants to know, somebody asked, can we do this bigger? It might have been him. The horses, could they go bigger?
Have to get the heads a little better than I did, but you could do it bigger. I would go find some horse heads and try to get the refinement, but you could do the whole idea of this there.
Yeah.
You know, I just sort of refine it. It's all, that almost looks like they're sort of in the rain, doesn't it? Sort of this sort of drippy.
Yeah, they look wet. They could have been running through the river.
Yeah, just
playing around, yeah, having fun.
Absolutely. Just, you know, they absolutely look wet. You know?
Ginger, are you in the book as a child?
Yes, I'm in the book as a child. As a child.
Oh, wait, Ginger's still muted. There you go.
Yes, I'm in the book as a child. People are
Thank
asking.
Thank you, Steffi Jane.
I have one chapter. They adopted 5 children. In this book, there's one chapter for us. The rest is all about other things, right? But they did mention they adopted 5 children. Though you can't believe how many of their friends never knew. You could go, because none of our pictures were ever out on the coffee table where anybody would notice. I don't know. I think we would have had to have won the Nobel Peace Prize to get a mention, you know. It sounds a little bitter, doesn't it? But I'm just saying, you know, I mean, everybody kind of on the planet knows my daughter is Cinnamon, and they've known it all along. I'm not, maybe I got a little crazy about that because I was never mentioned. But the joke was, I was the favorite kid. Here's a picture of me as a little kid, and I look very much like my granddaughter, Luna.
Yeah.
This is a picture of me as a little
kid.
Or
is Luna more like you?
Well, Luna's probably more like me, seeing how there. Yeah. There's a picture of my sister, she died at the age of 63. There's my artistic brother, Jensen. He said he never wanted to live to be an old person, and he didn't.
Well, he fulfilled his dream.
And there's my oldest brother, Dennis, who was in the military and also a lawyer, and that's the group of us all leaning over the fence. Jensen, me, Jeannie, Jay, and Dennis.
And Jay's still with us, right?
Jay is still with us. He'll be 80 next year.
This year.
This year, this November. Oh, yeah, and there's the group of us when I was first went to live with them. And there were my brothers and my sister and I with our cats. Posse's the first. There was like five posse's. Every time we went away to summer camp, the cats would disappear. I had no idea she was taking them to the pound. I lived with Lucretia Borgia. I just don't know what happened to your cat, honey. We'll get you another one.
Posse too.
Finally, I named the last one Patches because I thought maybe Posse's was bad luck. And it was something about that. Patches did survive and stayed with me till she ended up living with my sister. Jeannie got a gray cat named Tinkerbell, and I had Posse's. Then I had Patches. She was a calico cat, and I had her. And she used to meet me at the bus stop.
And race you back to the room.
And
back to the
race
house.
Me back to, you know, to the house. I was a great cat. And my mother, you know, believed cats should live outside. And so we'd sneak her. They'd come in the house. They had to leave at night. And she'd hide in the closet till mother left. Do you have a cat here? No.
Cat, what cow? What meowing?
What cat? No. And I'd put all my stuffed animals in my bed. And sometimes the cat would be in the covers. And she'd be doing this on the bed, you know. Do you have a cat? No cat. No cat here. All right, so there's our
Who wrote the book?
My father, William J. Wilkins, wrote the book, my adopted father. It's called The Sword and the Gavel. It's about his life. And there was a picture of my mother when she was younger. She was like 43 or something when she adopted these five kids. They couldn't have any kids, so... They were, and you know, in those days it was kind of tough because women would get together
to
parties,
kids.
And if you didn't have a kid, you had no conversation because women didn't work. You had nothing to say at a cocktail party. It just made you feel terrible, right? So, and there's a picture of my pony.
What's the pony's name?
Buster.
Oh, that's Buster.
And there's the Jeep I learned to drive on. So, there you go.
Well, that explains a lot. And that is why you don't drive Patty.
Learn to drive it. I was going to sign this one. Oh, we did sign it. Just got to do the. Did I do a slice? Yeah, I did. Everybody's.
Wait a minute. That's the one. Okay. That's the first bowl.
Oh, here's the second one. Thank you. That's the second one. I just moved everything out.
There you go.
There's our second bowl. There's our abstract horse. If you haven't been part of, people say, why would I want to join the Academy real quick? This was the weekly release this week.
A lady
reading a book. Originally it was done in 1895 by an English author, artist named Steer. Steer, right?
Steer.
Yeah.
Steer.
S-T-E-E-R.
Yeah. Philip.
Philip.
And so
I love this picture. I'm such a book fan of books myself. This speaks a lot to me. And anyway, if it speaks to you, become an Academy member. And really, we've got some awesome paintings every week. We give you something different to paint, from one cookie to a bunch of cookies. This has got great stuff coming up. And keep in touch, you guys, and keep in the loop and have fun painting. Thanks for watching.
So today was Monday, so we'll be back.
Sunday. At 1 o'clock.
Sunday at noon.
And look for some, during the week, look for some of these ginger gems.
Or it would like to know, can you bring the book on the cruise?
Sure. Good idea. I could bring the book art, sure.
If we remember. Let us know, Art, if you want us to bring the painting with us or if you want us to mail it. All right, anything else?
I think we're done. Thanks, guys.
You think we're done. Sammy and Judy, fire up the tunes.
Subscribe.
Please.
Tell your friends, please.
And thank you.
Thank you.
Take that over. Sammy and Judy, you're on deck.
I'm a student, I say with glee, of Ginger Cook's Academy. Take your time and do not rush. Use ruby satin, silver brush. Don't use black and mix the green. Learn what blend and grayscale mean. Yes, I hope each day to earn coaching praises as I learn. I'll be an artist, wait and see. Ginger means the world to me.